Children, how are you all? I hope you all are studying well. Yes. So welcome back to our EVS 1 Science class, Standard 5th. Before beginning the lesson, I will ask you some questions. As we all know, this year, due to coronavirus, we are having our lessons online. So we all are attending online lessons by using our mobile phones or laptop. Am I right? Yes. So because of using it again and again, your mobile battery or laptop battery gets low. Sometimes mobile gets switched off. So when your mobile gets switched off or when battery gets low, what is the next thing you do? Can you tell me? Yes, we put our mobile phone for charging. So when we put our mobile phone for charging, what happens? Our mobile starts working again. Am I right? Yes. Why? So because electricity is provided to it. And so electricity is very important to give energy to the mobile. So as energy is given with the help of the electricity, so our mobile starts working again, and again we can do our lessons very well. So in the same manner, what are we supposed to do when we feel very tired or when we feel very lazy, restless? Sometimes our energy also gets low by doing some different heavy physical activities. Am I right? Yes. So when electricity is not provided, the mobile gets switched off. So same way, exactly in the same manner, what is the most important thing which is important for us to get energy? If that thing is not supplied to us, we will also get very tired, we will become restless, we will become lazy, and even our battery will become low because we don't have energy in our body. So if we want to feel again energetic, so what we are supposed to do? Can you guess? Yes? Yes. So to remain energetic or active, the most important thing is the food which comes in our mind. And as we have holidays now, you must be having your food, your breakfast on time. Right? Yes. So same way, when we feel lazy or when we feel very hungry or when our body battery becomes low, what happens? We eat food or we have snacks. So food is important, essential for all living things. Food is very important for us or essential for us. So food is the important thing which comes in our mind. So food provides us energy or gives us energy, and then we become very active. So food is important for us in our for our life. So we are going to study a new lesson, Food for All, which is related to food, which is presented by Ms. Shilpa Ribello. The first topic is agriculture. What do you mean by crops? Can you see these crops here? Yes. So when these same types of plants, they are grown in a large scale means in big quantity. So it is known as crop. We call it as crops. And we get food from plants. We get food from plants. And because of that, we sow grains in the fields. To get good crops, what we do? We get food from that. So we sow grains in the fields. And also we plant fruit trees in the orchards. That is small garden. So about 60% of the land of our country is used for agriculture. We sow the seeds, we get good crops, and also along with that we plant the fruits trees. So along with that, for that purpose, about 60% of land of our country, of our India, is used for agriculture, for farming. Now there are two main agriculture seasons in our country. We are going to see about three, but the main important seasons are, agriculture seasons are only two. That is the Kharif season and the Rabi season. I repeat, there are two main agriculture seasons in our country. First is Kharif season and the second is Rabi season. And the third one is summer season. So now we will see one by one. The season from June to October is called as Kharif season. The season which starts from June to October, that is June, July, August, September and October. So this is called as Kharif season. Now June to October is a rainy season. So that means which crops are grown in the rainy season. Which crops are grown in the rainy season from June to October are called as Kharif crops. They are called as Kharif crops. So the season from June to October is called as Kharif crops, and the crops grown during that time are called as Kharif crops. Now in this season, the crops are watered mainly by the rain. Why? Because June to September is the rainy season. So whichever the crops are grown in this season, in these months from June to October, the rainwater is being directly given to them. They get the water from the rain. So these crops are watered mainly by the rain. So this is about the Kharif season. Here there are examples: rice, maize, cotton, groundnut. There are many more, but they are known as, so they are known as Kharif crops. Why? Because they are grown in rainy season from June to October. So they are known as Kharif crops. I hope so you have understood. Second, Rabi season. The season from October to March is called as Rabi season. The season from October to March, that is October, November, December, January, February and March. So this, during this months, whichever the crops are grown is known as Rabi crops. So the season from October to March is called as Rabi season. So The crops which are grown in this winter season, now October to Jan is the winter season. Mostly till Feb we have the winter season. So this crops which are grown during this season, during winter season, they are called as rabi season, rabi crops. And in this season, from where do they get water? The rain water that has soaked into the soil are the sources of water for the crops. That means the rain water from June to September, whatever the rain water we got, that water has soaked into the soil, that water has gone into the soil, in the ground, and that water is the source of for the crops. From there the crops get the water. So I repeat again, the crops which are grown from October to March, they are known as rabi crops. The season from October to March is called as rabi season. Here are the examples: wheat, mustard, almonds, oat. There are many more, but we will see few. So here they are rabi crops. So these plants, these crops get the water from the soil, which is soaked during the rainy season. The third one is summer season. The season from March to June is called the summer season. March, April, May, June. So this season, this is the summer season, hot season. So the season starts from March to June is called the summer season. And which crops we get? Watermelon, cucumber, mango, muskmelon. So all these crops, you can see in the picture, watermelon is here. Here is the cucumber. Here is the mangoes. So all these crops are grown during the summer season. And they get water from the help of the soil. Next topic is agriculture work. Every farmer wishes to get good harvest, and a good harvest provides a good income. Now what do you mean by good harvest? Harvest means the good crops. Good crops, grains, food, whatever they have sowed it, they have grown it. So every farmer thinks about it, that we should have good crops. And when I say I will sell these crops, then I should get good money, good income, good amount. So every farmer wishes to get a good harvest, and that good harvest provides them a good income. They get good amount. So for to get the good harvest, what things are essential for good harvest? What things we need? We need fertile land. Second is good quality of seeds, fertilizers, and availability of water. So what is essential for good harvest? First, fertile land. Second, good quality of seeds. Third, fertilizers. And fourth is availability of water. See here in this picture. That means fertile land means the land should be in the proper condition. It should be fertile. You can't grow crops anywhere. So the land should be fertile. It should be in good quality. Then second, seeds. the seeds which we sow in the land, it should be of good quality. If you use the good quality seeds, then only you get a good crops. Then fertilizers means the pesticides, insecticides. We can say as medicine for the crops. So the crops should not be damaged by the insects, small ants. So the pesticides, insecticides or medicines are provided to the crops. And the last main important is water. The availability of water should be good, in good quantity and time to time. Then only we can get a good crops, that is good harvest. So these four things are very important. I repeat again. First one is fertile land. Second, good quality of seeds. Third, fertilizers. And fourth, availability of water. It is also necessary to carry out the task of tilling the land. Tilling means to cultivate. We should make use of that land. We should make use of the land. We should cultivate the crops over there. And these crops in the field must be protected as such from the insecticide. We should give the medicines, insecticides and pesticides. This will be protected by the micro, small ants. And when the crops are grown well, when they are harvested, they should be stored safely. We can't keep the crops anywhere. So these crops should be stored in a safe place. So all of these processes are very important to grow crops and to keep it safe, to earn money. But the population of our country is increasing. It is not decreasing, it is still increasing and increasing. But still, the needs of all people are being met. Each and every person get food to eat. Why? Because of improved methods of agriculture. Now this agriculture method is being improving day by day, year by year. The technology is being improved, and because of that the methods of agriculture are improving, and because of the methods of agriculture are improving, we all people get their needs. They get each and every thing. The next topic is traditional agriculture. Traditional means the ancient. In traditional methods of agriculture, ploughing and tilling etc. were done with the help of oxen. Ancient means we can say as the olden days, past time. Here you can see the picture. The ploughing is done by the help of the oxen. The ploughing, to cultivate, tilling, this all is being done with the help of oxen. A mot. Mot means a huge leather bag. If you see in the picture, here you can see the picture. Here is the leather bag. So a huge leather bag, which is known as mot. It is driven with the help of oxen to draw water from well. Now we have the pumps, machines, but previous past times they were having a pair of oxen. With the help of the oxen, they draw water from well. हार्वेस्टिंग थ्रेशिंग एक्सेट्रा वॉज डन बाय द मेम्बर्स ऑफ द फार्मर्स फैमिली themselves with the help of oxen. After growing the crops are ready, then they used to remove the crops, then thresh it, make it separate. So all these things, all this were done by the help of their own family members. They are not calling the others, but only their family members used to help them with the help of the oxen. However, farmers now carry out all these tasks with the help of machine. If you see in the picture here, instead of bullocks, they have the tractors for ploughing. Then here, for harvesting, for threshing, they have the machines. So, because farmers nowadays they are making use of these machines for growing the crops. Next topic is improved methods of agriculture. To improve seeds, earlier it was customary to preserve the seeds of one harvest for sowing in the next season. Means this year, whatever the seeds are, they used to preserve and keep it for the next year, to sow the seeds for the next year. Earlier it was like that. Earlier it was a customary to preserve. It was a duty to preserve the seeds of one harvest of this year for the next year. But nowadays, improved seeds are developed through research. So whichever the last year's seeds they were keeping for the next year, with that they were not having the good income. The quality was going low. But nowadays, improved seeds are developed through research. With the help of the research, with the help of the new technologies, the seeds are improving. The improved seeds have come, the good quality seeds have come. So, and they are available in the market for every crop such as jawar, rice, groundnut, wheat, etc. Still there are many. So this improved good quality of seeds have come in the market. Now, what are the advantages of improved seeds? What are the good things of the improved seeds? First one is they have a higher yield. Higher yield means they are in good condition. They have the higher income. The seeds are in good quality. And the good quality means the good crops. And if the good crops are grown, naturally they get a good income, good amount. Second is they can resist pest attacks. Resist means they stop. So there are less, because of this improved seeds, there are less insects, less ants, and so because of this the insecticides and pesticides are less. Third one, some varieties become ripe for harvesting in a shorter period of time. Some varieties of grains, of crops, become ripe for harvesting in a less period of time. Fourth is, some give a high yield even with a low water supply. If the water is less, if the water is provided less, even though some seeds give a good crops, they grow well. They never wait for water, but they grow well and with for the good income. So they say as some give a high yield, good income, good crops, even with a low water supply. If the water is less, provided less to them, even they grow well. So there are four advantages of improved seeds. Next is modern methods of irrigation. Crops grow well if they are watered at the right time. Yes, if the water is provided to the crops at the right time to time, then the crops grow very well. From where they get water? Water from rivers, lakes and wells is used for irrigation in addition to rainwater. Here you can see river, lakes, wells. So they get water from rivers, lakes and wells, and also from rainwater. So from where the plants were getting water or the crops were getting water? From rivers, from lakes and wells, but also from the rainwater. And to store this rainwater for a longer time, they were building dams. If you can see here, they were building dams so that the water can be stored here for the greater quantities, for the longer period of time. However, much water from the canals is lost due to evaporation and seepage into the ground. So this damp water was stored over there, and when the dam doors are open, this water flows with the help of these canals. And because of that, the farmers used to get water from the canals. But due to the hot sun, this water evaporates. It goes in the sky with the help of in the form of water vapor. So the water becomes less in the canal, and even some of the water goes down into the ground, in the soil. That is known as seepage. Seepage into the ground. So much water was being loose from these canals due to evaporation and seepage. Now, improved methods of irrigation are used. Because of this, the farmers were not getting sufficient water for the crops. So now, to avoid that and to get the good crops and to avoid the water loss of water, the improved methods of irrigation are used. So what are they? There are two modern methods of irrigation. First is drip irrigation and second is sprinkle irrigation. I repeat, there are two modern methods of irrigation. First is drip irrigation and second is sprinkle irrigation. We are going to see one by one. Here is the drip irrigation. Can you see the pipe and the plant? There is a hole in the pipe near the plant. Okay, so here it is. Deep irrigation method makes use of pipes with hole. If you see in the picture, there is a big pipe and the holes are being provided. So this ensures that the required amount of water drips only near the plants. See, if you can see here. So whatever the water, amount of water is needed, it goes only to that particular plant. And because of this, the water is not wasted. So plants also get sufficient water, and along with that, the water also is not wasted. See here, if you can see. Here are the some of the examples. So thus full use is made of the available water. Last one is sprinkle irrigation. The second method is sprinkle irrigation. You must have seen this sprinkles in the gardens. If you are going, so you can see the sprinkle irrigation, and this makes use of sprinkles of different sizes that spray water on plants. So these sprinkles spray water only on plants, and with this also the water is being saved. So these sprinkles are of different sizes, from some are small, some are big. You can see here in these pictures, some are big, some waters are gone. See here, some are small, some are big, in medium size. So with this, the water sprays on the plants. The water sprays on the plants. Some of the sprinkles are turning around. Now, what are the advantages of irrigation? What are the good things? First one, it provides enough water to the plants. The plants get sufficient water. Jitna chahiye utna. They get sufficient water. Second, with this help of deep irrigation and the sprinkle irrigation, we can save a lot of water. We can save lot of water. I hope you have understood. So I stop over here. Remaining part we will do in the next presentation. Children, here are some of the questions which you are supposed to write in your notebook. And please write it and learn it. By that, thank you very much. Stay home, stay safe.